Another video, and today we got my NFL week 16 predictions video. Week 16. What? I don't understand how it's week 16 already. We are coming up on Christmas time. It doesn't feel like it. It doesn't feel like it should be Christmas, but we got no choice. It's gonna be Christmas. I don't know. It's just something about it this year. Last year I felt like I was really sick, but I still felt in that Christmas mood because the Packers played on Christmas. That was really cool. But that's besides the point. Christmas is coming. This is a Christmas week of games. Should be a good old grand time. But before we get there, we have to talk about my record from last week. And that was 11-5, bringing my total season record up to 145-79, so pretty good, pretty decent still in the year. Still haven't hit that 100 losses mark, and have actually been doing pretty good within these past couple weeks. So yeah, let's just jump straight to the Thursday night matchup, and that'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Los Angeles Rams. Saints last week getting that big win over the Giants to keep their hopes in the NFC South race alive, and the Rams got the win over the Commanders to keep their playoff hopes alive. This should be a pretty interesting matchup, kind of a snooze fest, honestly. But this is the rematch of that one NFC Championship game where the no call happened. But that's in the past, and these are two different, totally different teams now. This should be a pretty interesting one. I just think I like the Rams offense a little better right now. Matthew Stafford has been playing like Matthew Stafford, and that receiving core with Puka and Kupp obviously has been really good. The Saints, they've been decent. I just don't know if I can trust their offense in the end of the day. So give me the Rams taking the big win on Thursday night. For the Saturday games, we got two Saturday games, both on, you could say, NBC. One NBC, one Peacock. You know. Starting with the Cincinnati Bengals taking on the Pittsburgh Steelers. The Bengals, they got a big win on Saturday last week, getting that win over the Vikings. Jake Browning, he's playing decent. He's playing decent. Keeping that playoff hope alive for them. And the Steelers, I don't remember what they do last week. The Steelers lost the Colts. That's right. Also on Saturday. So both these teams playing back-to-back Saturdays. Ha, funny. The Steelers have just not looked great recently. Ever since Kenny Pickett went out, it's been rough for them. It's been rough. And the Bengals, they haven't looked bad. You know, winning close, tight games with Jake Browning, able to pull it out. So I'm going to say they do it again here against their rivals, the Steelers. And give me the Cincinnati Bengals. Kitty goes meow. Getting to the Saturday night game, you have the Buffalo Bills taking on the Los Angeles Chargers. Chargers, they got 63 points dropped on them last week. Nothing crazy. Nothing wild. Just embarrassing. Just embarrassing. But they, in the good part of that, they fire Brandon Staley. You love to see it for Chargers fans. All five of them. And usually, you know, who's going to be their interim head coach? I don't know. If it's Kellen Moore, they're even more screwed. Yikes. Yikes, that's all I have to say. And then the Bills, obviously getting that big win over the Cowboys. James Cook was cooking. And I think they're going to continue it this week. So usually a team has success after they fire their head coach. But this Bills team has been firing back and been getting back in that win column. And I think they're going to continue it here with should be a pretty easy win over not so great of a team like the Chargers. So give me Joshua Allen and the Buffalo Bills. Next up, you have the Indianapolis Colts taking on the Atlanta Falcons. Falcons taking a rough L to the Panthers last week. The Panthers! God help me. How did we lose to this Falcons team earlier in the season? I don't understand it. Oh, God. And now my Packers played the freaking Panthers this week, but we'll get to that soon. And then the Colts getting the win over the Steelers last week in a big-time victory. Gardner Minshew is playing like Gardner Minshew. He's playing well, playing good. I mean, yeah, I don't see the Falcons having a chance. This Colts team has been playing to as high of standards, so give me the Colts getting another win here against the Falcons this week. And speaking of my Packers, we're not going to get to my Green Bay Packers taking on the Carolina Panthers. Oh, God. This might get dicey. I hope it doesn't, though. Last week, my Packers taking the L to the Bucks. I almost said Falcons because they were on my mind. And then the Panthers getting that win over the Falcons in close fashion. Bryce Young getting his second win. Love to see it. I swear, on everything that is holy, if my Green Bay Packers lose to the Carolina Panthers, I might have to quit. I might have to quit. I think I said this last week, too. Say if we lost to the Bucks, I would literally quit being a Packers fan. Well, so much for that. Yeah, if we lose to the Panthers, though, I'm ending it. I'm ending it! Gonna take my Packers. We need this bounce back win in a big way. So, go Pack go, I guess. You have the Cleveland Browns taking on the Houston Texans. The Browns getting that big comeback victory over the Chicago Bears last week. Barely holding it on, getting that interception at the end. And then the Texans, they got the win over the Titans last week, going up to 8-6. And you know what? See, on paper, Browns are 9-5. Texans are 8-6. Theoretically, the Browns should win this game. But I don't know. I feel like I trust this Texans offense more than I do the Browns offense. Yes, the Browns have looked pretty good recently with Joe Flacco as their quarterback, and that's great and all. But I'm going to take youth over wise men here with C.J. Stroud getting the win over the Cleveland Browns. Give me the Texans. I never thought I'd say that, but they need this win. That'll make both these teams 9-6 if the Texans do win this game. And they need it so they can get in that playoff hunt or get in that playoff picture. You know what I'm saying? So, oh my God, give me the upset win with the Texans here. Screw it. Next up, you have the Detroit Lions taking on the Minnesota Vikings. Vikings taking an L to the Bengals last week. Ha ha, you suck. Nick Mullins, garbage in front of his son. That's all they showed during the game. You thought it was like Taylor Swift, dude. Kidding. And then the Lions, they got a huge win on Saturday over the Broncos. Looking like that Lions team that we haven't been seeing in recent history. And I think with that being said, these two teams play also in Week 18, I'm pretty sure. But with this one, when the standards are high, and I'm pretty sure the Lions have already, I think with this game, they might clinch the, yeah, I'm pretty sure if the Lions win this game, they clinch the North. They might have clinched the North last week. I'm not sure. But with that being said, give me the Detroit Lions. Blue Kitty goes meow. Dan Campbell, bite kneecaps. You already know. And next up, we got a barn burner. You have the Washington Commanders taking on the New Jersey Jets. It'll be the 32nd ranked defense in the Commanders taking on
the 32nd ranked offense in the Jets. Whoa, this is about to get wild. Sam Howell, and I think still Zach Wilson. I could be wrong. I don't know, Chief. See, the Commanders, they've lost like 5-6 in a row. The Jets, they've kind of had a rough schedule. So, give me the worst offense getting the win over the worst defense. Offense wins championships. You heard it here first, folks. Kidding. Jokes. Funny jokes. But give me the Jets. Next up, you got the Seattle Sea Chickens, Seahawks, getting the win. Taking on the Tennessee Titans. Should be a pretty interesting one here. The Seahawks getting that insane Monday night victory over the Eagles. What? I don't understand. I literally don't understand anymore. The Titans, they took that L to the Texans, as we said earlier on. See, maybe the Titans win. I'd love to see if the Titans won, because that'd be cool and all. Yes, I don't think Drew Lock is a comparable quarterback, so I wouldn't be surprised if the Titans won. But give me the Seahawks, especially with this momentum they are riding here. So, give me Seattle in this one. Next up, you got the Jacksonville Jaguars taking on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Bucks, obviously, getting that win over my Green Bay Packers last week. I want to die. And then the Jags taking an L on Sunday night to the Ravens. Not really shocking. Their offense just couldn't get anything going. And that's all the Bucks did last week. They got things going. Baker Mayfield. Bacon. He was bacon, dude. He was cooking up. But I think in this situation here, the Jaguars, they really need that bounce back win. They've been looking for weeks now. They've, like, on a 3-4 game losing streak. It's getting out of hand. And they're down to 8-6. They need to win a game, for gosh sakes. So, give me the Jags getting the win, trying to hopefully, yeah, give me the Jags. T-Law getting the win over Baker here. Screw it. Battle of Florida here. Jacksonville against Tampa. Love to see it. Next up, you have the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Chicago Bears. Bears choking last week. You guys suck. Literally, you had the game in your hands, threw a deep bomb up, and it's dropped by Darnell Mooney. Y'all suck. Cardinals getting absolutely mollywopped against the 49ers. Not really a shocker there. This is a toilet bowl, if I've ever seen it. But out of this toilet bowl, I feel like the Bears are just the better team at this point. The Cardinals, yeah, they have Kyler Murray back. He's been playing actually kind of decent. He's been looking good. But I just don't think it's enough here. The Bears, they need a win after taking a rough one last week. So, give me the Bears, I guess. Next up, you have the Dallas Cowgirls taking on the Miami Dolphins. Cowboys, obviously, taking a fat L against the Buffalo Bills. I called it. And then the Dolphins. They obviously got that big win over the Jets, just blowing them out last week. Just ridiculous. So this should be a pretty interesting game. Tyreek Hill, if he comes back, I think the Dolphins win this game. The Cowboys, they're on a slump now, and they're going to just keep losing more if they're in this slump. And the Dolphins, yes, they haven't beaten above 500 team. But the Cowboys, they barely have beaten above 500 team just a couple times. And last week, they take a fat L to the Bills. It's not looking good for them. But I think the Dolphins can get a huge win here, proving that they can be that team. So, yeah, give me the Dolphins, especially if Tyreek comes back. If Tyreek doesn't come back, it could get dicey, but I'm still going to take the Dolphins winning this one against a struggling Cowboys team. So, Give me the Dolphins. Mike McDaniel, best coach in the league. You already know what it is.
Getting to the Sunday night matchup, you have the New England Patriots taking on the Denver Broncos. The Pats taking a fat L to the Chiefs. Is anybody shocked? No. The Broncos taking a fat L to the Lions. Is anybody shocked? No. Russell Wilson looking like Russell Wilson again, just looking trash. But I think it's hard to look trash against the Patriots. You know, the Patriots, they're the worst team in the league. I'm going to say it. I think they could be worse than the Panthers. I'm going to say it. They're garbage. They're trash. They're the worst. They suck. Billy Belichick, get him out of here. Give me the Broncos on Sunday night, picking up a big win here. And let's get to our Christmas Day games, starting with the Las Vegas Raiders taking on the Kansas City Chiefs on Nickelodeon. Yep, Nickelodeon. Oh, God. The Raiders here. Last week, they dropped 63 points on the Chargers. What? Chiefs got a win over the Patriots. Not really impressive at all, but they got a win. And Rashee Rice dropped 24-plus points. What? Just ridiculous. And rematch from earlier in the year where the Raiders choked that big lead. Are they gonna do it again? Probably. Yes, they dropped 63 last week, but it was also the Chargers, and it was also a Thursday night game. Anything can happen. You know, anything can happen. The Chiefs could lose this game, but I don't see it happening. They need a big-time win over a rival like the Raiders. Max Crosby and Patrick Mahomes going at it once again. So, give me the defending Super Bowl champions in the Chiefs. Next up, you have the New Jersey Giants, we can call them New Jersey again, taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. I'm going to start calling them the freaking Pennsylvania Eagles because, God, is that an insult? Not really, but God, they've been looking rough. Three-game losing streak. And the Giants, the Tommy DeVito train finally comes to an end. And is that going to continue? I think so, because the Eagles, they need a big win. They need it bad. And they're playing not a good team at all in the Giants. So, if the Eagles lose this one, throw any bets you had on them away. Throw them away. So, give me the Eagles with the win here on Christmas. And for the Christmas night game, Monday Night Football, you have 11-3. Taking on 11-3. It's the Baltimore Ravens at the San Francisco 49ers. Best of the AFC. Taking on the best of the NFC. This is about to get good. Lamar against Brock Purdy. Two MVP favorites. Also on the 49ers. Another MVP favorite in Christian McCaffrey. Going nuts last week on the Cardinals. Ravens obviously getting that big win on Sunday night. I think any of these two teams can win. I think the Ravens could easily, you know, just pull off some sort of crazy game. Like a Lamar Jackson masterclass. But it's going to be hard against this 49ers offense. See, my personal opinion, I don't think Brock Purdy is the MVP favorite like everybody's saying he is. He's a check down merchant. Just my opinion. But Christian McCaffrey has just been carrying this offense on their backs. And I think he's going to continue to do that here, as I am going to take the 49ers. I wouldn't be surprised if this wide receiver core gets going against this. It's not a bad secondary, but when, you know, guys like Travarius Ward isn't in there, if he's not in there, it might get rough for that secondary. So give me the 49ers. But this could easily go down as game of the year, and I'm excited for it. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed this video today. I gotta edit this, get it out to you guys as usual. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Please comment, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when I post a new video. Bye, guys. Yeah, see those Mayweather, Porsche, lay right together with you.